Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, brothers and friends all over the world, may God bless you. Thank God this evening for another pretty evening, another wonderful evening. We bless God for today being Sunday. I want us to pray before we go into our service. Heavenly Father, we thank you because you are the Alpha and Omega. I am that I am, we honor you. You are God that never fail, never change. Lord God, we lift a time like this before your hand, and we ask you, Jehovah God, let the anointing that destroyed the yokes come upon us. Father God, we ask you, take over and take control, take your seat, oh Lord, for when you take your seat, Jehovah God, you will do impossible to be possible. When you take your place, Holy Spirit, you will teach us, you will direct us, you will lead us. We ask you tonight, take over and take control. We ask you, reign and rule in our midst. We ask you, glorify Christ, Spirit of the living God. You are welcome. You are welcome in our midst. Glorify our Lord Jesus Christ. I do not know what to say, what to speak, but you know your word will be upon me. In Jesus' mighty name, your hand, O Lord. Lord God, use me mightily under my office of calling in the mighty name of Jesus, that somebody tonight will be blessed. In Jesus' mighty name, somebody praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for your goodness. Hallelujah. You are welcome. You are welcome. My son from Italy, you are welcome. You are welcome. I see some of you coming in. God bless you. Our daddy, God bless you. It's going to be a wonderful night. It's going to be a powerful night. I say, God bless every one of you. God bless every one of you. All of you that are coming in. I say, God bless you. God honor you. God strengthen you and honor your day for you in Jesus' name, and cause your life to smile in the name of Jesus. This is a night of prophetic, a night of blessing. It's a night of blessing, and somebody who is online will be blessed. And as many of you, I saw Pastor Jeff from Italy. God bless you and your family. God bless every one of you that are coming in right now. I pray that God will touch every one of us. Today is going to be another wonderful evening. Let us go and worship God and praise him for who he is. Yes, you are the Lord Most High. Yes, you are the Lord. You are the Lord Most High, oh God. Yes, you are the Lord. You are the Lord Most High. Yes, you are the Lord. You are the Lord Most High God. Yes, you are the Lord, Ancient of Days Most High. Yes, you are the Lord. You are the Lord Most High. Forever you will be. Forever Jesus is Lord. He's the Lamb upon the throne. He's the Lamb upon the throne. I gladly bow my knees. I gladly bow my knees to you, Lord. I worship you, O Lord. All heavens declare. All heaven declare the glory of the risen God. Oh, can I compare you? Who can I compare you with the beauty of our glorious God? Hallelujah. Forever you will be. Forever Jesus is Lord. He's the Lamb upon the throne. He's the Lamb upon the throne. I gladly bow my knees. I gladly bow my knees. Oh Lord, I worship you, oh Lord. Oh, the blood of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus, oh Lord. Thank you for the blood of Jesus, my God. Thou washest bright as though. There is power, power wonder working power in the blood, Lord, of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. I love the man of Galilee. Yes, Lord. For he has done so very much for me, Lord Jesus. He has forgiven me all my sins and said the Holy Ghost to me. I love the man of Galilee. I love you, Jesus. I love the man. I love Jesus from Galilee. Oh, Lord our God. For he has done so very much for me. Oh, Lord God. He has forgiven me all my sins and sent the Holy Ghost to me. I love the man. I love the man of Galilee. He's not by might. He's not by might. He's not by power. Oh, Lord, by my spirit, he says the Lord, the strength of this. It's not by might, it's not by might, it's not by power, oh Lord, by my spirit, says the Lord, the strength of this. This mountain has been removed, oh Lord, this mountain will be removed in Jesus' name. Every mountain must be removed, oh Lord, by my spirit, says the Lord. Father, we thank you, mighty mover. We bless you tonight, our Lord, our God. We thank you, the light of the world. We thank you, the salt of the world, the ancient of days, the miracle working God, the Alpha and Omega, the Jehovah Nissi, the Lord that we call upon and atmosphere change, the one that is our sure foundation, our rock, our fortress, our refuge, our hiding place. We come once more to you tonight to bless you, to worship you, to ask you, oh Lord, prophetically, oh Lord, release word over our lives, over your children's life tonight, oh Lord. Word that we change our life, that we change our situation. Father God, we thank you for tonight will be a great night. We thank you for your great God. We thank you for your wonderful God. We thank you for your powerful God. We ask you, Daddy, reign and rule in our midst. We ask you, ancient of death, take over and take control. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Somebody praise the Lord. Well done, well done, well done. We are chasing Jesus and we will find him. When Mary Magdalene chased her, he found him. He found him in the house of a rich man where they asked, what is she doing? But she knows what she was doing. This night we come to chase you, oh Lord. We will find you, Jehovah God. As we call you, Lord, you will change our story. You will speak into our stories. You will speak into our lives. Thank you, oh Lord. Thank you. I see my people, the ones from Italy, the ones from New York, our pastor, Pastor Stephanie from New York. God bless you. I see my son from Italy, my daughter from Italy, my daughters, Mercy and Gladys. May God bless every one of you. It's going to be a wonderful night. It's a night, God, we speak it to your situation in a special way. It's a night, God, will top you up. Amen. Hallelujah. It's a night for you to overflow. It's a night of overflow. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We worship you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. I want to, because it's a prophetic night. Prophetic night. It is about declaring the word of God, prophesying the word of God into people's life. And then if God decides to take us deeper in the spirit realm regarding your issue, regarding anybody, you will receive the word. But this night, we start tonight with the word of God. The Bible told us in the book of Jeremiah chapter 7, verse 23, he said to us, he said, obey my voice and I will be your God. And you shall be my people and walk in my ways that I have commanded you, that it may be well with you. Tonight I said it will be well with you in Jesus' mighty name. It's a night God has set aside to make you to feel well in life. It will be well with you. The Bible told us in the book of Jeremiah 31:25. He said to us, he said, Jeremiah 31:25. He said to us, he said, for oh, praise the Lord. He said to us, for I have satisfied the weary souls, and I have replenished every sorrowful soul. Tonight, in Jesus' mighty name, heaven will replace. God is going to satisfy your soul. He promised us that he will satisfy our souls in droughts. In Jesus' mighty name, he said, night the Lord will satisfy your soul. In the mighty name of Jesus, he will satisfy your soul. He will satisfy you. He will satisfy you. In the name of Jesus, every area that you are weary, God said he will replenish. He will replenish every sorrowful soul. The Lord is replacing your soul tonight in Jesus' name with his abundant blessing, with his abundant mercy, with his abundant love. In the name of Jesus, he said to us in the book of Psalm 23, I am the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes tonight the Lord, you will see the hand of the Lord. You will not want because the Lord is your shepherd. The Lord is your king. He will walk before you as we go before him tonight. And he told us in the book of Isaiah 14, verse 14. He said, but Zion said, the Lord has forsaken me, and my Lord has forgotten me. And then 15 said, can a woman forget her suckling child that she should not have compassion on the son of a womb? Yea, they may forget, yet will I not forget thee. Father, we thank you because tonight you are telling somebody you will not forget him. God is not going to forget you. God will be with you. God is not going to change your story. God will be with you. We pray today in Jesus' mighty name that the Lord will not forget your life, that God will not forget your life, that God will remember you, will remember his promises. He will remember everything he has said about you. He promised you here. He said, yes, if you obey me, he said, I will be your God. May the living God be your God indeed. May the ancient of days be your God. May you see him as your God. May you see him as your Jehovah. As he come, as he speak for you today, in Jesus' mighty name, you will see the hand of God, that God is your God. There was a man in the Bible that his family were known as poor family. They were known, they don't have anything. They are poor and wretched. They don't have nothing. They didn't know them as, this thing started again. Oh Lord, what is this? They know them as people who don't have anything. They know them as somebody who don't have any good thing at all. But thank God for God who knows us, who sees us. His blood type is not showing. Okay. Oh Lord. Okay. The Bible said to us, Second Samuel. That's our main text. Please go to our main text, Second Samuel. 2 Samuel chapter 6. Anytime I read that place, I'm so happy. That's where I want to stand tonight, to start blessing you, to start prophetically declaring the word of God over you. The Bible said to us in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 6 from verse 7, he said, he told us about a man called Uzziah went and touched what is not supposed to touch, the ark of God. When he touched the ark of God, because he was with David, he didn't remember that he had boundaries. He didn't remember that he cannot touch where he shouldn't touch. But he went and touched it. But when he touched it, something happened. I want you to know that any hand that have touched you has touched untouchable, unless they touch you in love. If they touch you in anger, from tonight, God will begin to cut them down. In the name of Jesus, any hand that have touch your destiny, any hand that have touched your future, any hand that have touched your blessing, any hand that have touched anything that concern you, I see the Lord cutting them down. In the mighty name of Jesus, the Bible says in verse 7, he said, and the anger of God was kindled against Uzziah, and God smote him. God smote him there for his error, and there he died by the act of God. Verse 8 said, and David was displeased because the Lord had made a blemish upon Uzziah, and he called the name of the place Paraphase to this day. Verse 9, and David was afraid of the Lord that day, and said, how shall the ark of the Lord come to me? So David would not remove the ark of God into his own city of David, but David carried it aside into the house of Obed-Edom the Gigathite, and the ark of the God continued in the house of Obed-Edom the Gigathite 3 months. And the Lord blessed Obed-Edom and all his house, all his household. 12. And it was told King David, saying, the Lord has blessed the house of Obed-Edom and all that pertaining unto him because of the ark of God. So David went and brought up the ark of God from the house of Obed-Edom into the city of David with gladness. This night in Jesus' mighty name, I'm going to prophesy to you by the power that is in the word of God, by through the spirit of the living God, that every power, that anything that kill others, what kill others will not kill you. In Jesus' mighty name, what kill others will not kill you, and God will do for you what no man can do for you. What they reject, what they thought that can destroy you, God will use it to make you. That is why you have to stay in him. That's why you have to look unto him. For God is about to do something. God is about to visit somebody. God will visit you tonight. What destroy others? Others can die around you, minus you. You will not die because your case is different. Because you are a worshiper. Obed-Edom was a worshiper. Obed-Edom, even though he was worshiping God from father to father, he was an instrumentalist in the church. He was playing. If you go through the history and read it very well, you will see the kind of person Obed-Edom is. But when this thing happened, because they are poor family, because they are the Gigathites, there are nobody in the community, and David decides he can send it there. And when the thing got there, he never knew that day that God is waiting to send his presence into his house. And when the presence came into the house, 3 months, somebody had declared 3 months. By the time you come out from what is happening now, 3 months, people will hear your story. 3 months, people will testify of you. 3 months, people will say, how did it happen? 3 months, people will see the hand of God. 3 months, there will be a change of story. 3 months, there will be a transformation. The Bible said, he sent the ark of God. Nowhere God's presence will be with you. Your life will remain the same. That is why daily I pray and I fast and I cry out to God on your behalf. Father, let your presence not depart from that house. Wherever house you are watching me now, the presence of God in the next 3 months will bring big story for you. We bring big changes for you. I declare that in 3 months time, you will hear God. You will see God in action in the name of Jesus. God will change your story. God will change your story. In 3 months time, there will be a great story. In 3 months time, there will be a great transformation. They said, when he had, they will hear. Then that had said, oh no, you will live there. That is the end. You cannot go, you cannot do better. But I declare 3 months time. Hey, even though we are coming out to face famine, but 3 months time, 3 months time. God said that you are, he said, he will replenish he said in famine time, he said your soul will not go dry. That's what the word of God said. So in 3 months time, from Cast from the time that you've been locked in until the time you're coming out. If Christ be with me, you will come out and testify. Lord, thank you that I was inside praying. Thank you that you locked me in. Thank you, they meant it for bad. They thought that it can destroy many of us, but God done it for good. I pray in the name of Jesus, in the next 3 months, you will see the hand of God. You will see the mercies of God. In 3 months' time, your story will change. In 3 months' time, you will jubilate and testify. In 3 months' time, it takes only 3 months for God to turn the story of Jabez around. It takes only 3 months. 1 day is enough. 1 day, 1 minute of God's presence, 1 minute of God's word can change your story. In 3 months' time, you will testify. In 3 months' time, I prophesy over your family. There will be joy. In 3 months' time, that are believing God for fruit of the womb, you will come out with the fruit of the womb. In 3 months' time, God will show you that he has loved you with everlasting love, that people can forget you, but he can never forget you. In 3 months' time, God, if you obey him, if you obey his voice, he will be your God. He will be with you. In 3 months' time, when God is with a man, who can be against him? When God is with you, he makes you a conqueror. When God is with you, he tells your story. In 3 months' time, I declare 3 months' time, somebody here will testify. In 3 months' time, you will see the hand of God upon your family, upon your situation. In the name of Jesus, everything that makes you fear, don't worry. The one that knows how to take fear and turn it to something favor, that God is our God. When you fear him, everything fear you. In 3 months' time, because of you don't fear him, whose I do not fear him, whose I thought that is God or religion, whose I don't know you have to reference God, whose I don't know that you can't just jump God anyhow. If you had the presence, don't mess him up. And that presence that destroyed Uzziah was the presence that made your big done. I see God visiting you. I see Jehovah God turning it around for you. What destroy others cannot destroy you. In 3 months' time, you will testify. In 3 months' time, you jubilate. In 3 months' time, you will say, Lord, thank you. If it is God to do what you have done for me, if it's not the Lord on my side, where would I have been? Is there broken? Your soul is being escaped like that of a bird in the name of Jesus, because your help is in the name of the Lord. He has come to help you. He that help you, that will remember you are happy. He will help you this month. He will help you in this lockdown. As you are sitting down, ideas, he'll be pouring ideas. He'll be pouring wisdom in you. He'll be pouring directions on you. He will be teaching you how to go in the name of Jesus. In 3 months' time, you will testify. I declare 3 months' time, somebody will testify. Somebody online will say, Lord, thank you for come and see what the Lord have done. Because you fear him, because you obey his voice, he will change it for you. And he will bring transformation. He said to us in the book of John 14, 15 and 21, he said, if you love me, keep my commandment. He who has my commandment and keep them, it is he who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. May God manifest himself. May heaven manifest itself where you are. Jehovah God will manifest himself in your life. A shepherd of this will manifest himself in your life. In the name of Jesus. He said, I will love him and I will manifest himself in his life. God will manifest himself. And your family will manifest itself. And that's our strength. That you don't know where you will get. In your bills that are piling up. Oh, in every situation, oh Lord, God will manifest himself. And that challenge that you don't know what to do, whether there is a Delilah behind walking against you, God will show up. Jehovah God will show forth in the name of Jesus. God said, I will manifest myself. When you obey me, I will manifest myself. May God manifest himself. In your working place, God will manifest himself. In your destiny, God will manifest himself. In your hope, God will manifest himself. In that every delay that you'll be waiting to hear good news, I declare and declare, God will manifest itself from tonight. God presence has entered into your house. God presence will be with you. God presence will not leave you. God presence will stay with you. I pray that God, that comforter, that comfortress, will touch you and will remember you. God presence will not depart from you in the name of Jesus. I pray in the mighty name of Jesus. As I prophesy to you tonight, 3 months, 3 months, God has visited Obididon. That God will visit you. Obididon from poverty to become a sought after man, become a gatekeeper of a city, become a man that cannot ask or they cannot do anything without him. Oh Lord, message was sent to the one, to the king who thought, if the thing is there, I destroy him, it doesn't matter. But God see it and said, no, I will not leave you, neither will I forsake you. I will visit you. I will turn it around. For I be seeing your cry, all those your secret cries in the secret places. God will visit you. God is about to turn it around. God will wipe your tears. God will wipe your tears. God will turn it around for you. It's your season. It's your season of jubilation. It's your season of testimony. God never fails. The Bible said when it turned, our pains, our shames around. We were like them that dream dreams. When you obey the commandment of God and stick to him, it can take God only one day to turn your life around. I pray in Jesus' mighty name, you are among the ones that will testify. This is your season of testimony. This is your season of testimony. 2020, no matter how bad the weather may be, no matter the storms, no matter the eyes of the storms of plague, my God is with you. He will show you mercy. He will turn your life around. None shall be found missing around you. None shall be found wanting. None shall be found missing. Your work will not be missing. Your no life will go in your family. No business will go in your family. No finance will lose you. In the name of Jesus, you will not lose faith. You will stand strong in the Lord. For the Lord has promised you. He said, I will visit you in the name of Jesus. And the Bible said again, in the book of John, chapter 2, verse 5 to 6, he said, whosoever keepeth his word, truly the love of God is the love of God is perfect in him. By this we know that we are in him. He who says he abides in him, him ought himself also to walk just as he walks. Obididon, walk just. Obididon, don't have any other thing but to serve God. What is it that you have? You don't have anything but you're serving God. I tell you something, that God that you're serving will soon visit you. He will soon show himself strong. He will soon change situation for you. He will soon tell the world that you are his precious one. In the name of Jesus. If we go to the book of Acts 28, Acts of Apostle 28, Acts of Apostle 28, the Bible makes us to understand from 1 to 10, the Bible said, that and he said, and when they were escaped, then they knew that the island was called Island of Malta, and the barbarian people showed them no little kindness, for they kindled a fire and received everyone because of the present rain and because of the cold. And when Paul had gathered a bundle of stick and laid them on the fire, there came out a viper out of the heat and fastened on his hand. I'm going to stop here. Peter went there. God sent Peter. Paul went there with his disciples. When Paul got to that place, the Bible said the barbarians, the vagabond boys, the area boys, they were there. They set up fire. The fire they set was not big enough because in the fire, it was raining. So the fire was not enough. I called you this night. We are going to set up fire. We have come tonight to set a fire, that that the fire will burn her, that the fire will be testified in our family. Whatsoever that has been affecting our family, the fire we set up tonight will smoke them out. They will come out in Jesus' mighty name. They will come out and be destroyed. They will come out and be wasted in the name of Jesus. The fire, when Paul saw it, he noticed that the fire is not intensive enough. He went and add more fire. Ah, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, I don't know how far you prayed, but I come to add my own fire with you. In Jesus' name, that the fire will begin to burn. The fire will burn. As the fire gets heated, as the fire was burning, as the fire come hotter, as the fire begin to expand, the Bible says the viper that was under the fire came out in the name of Jesus. Every viper that has been affecting your life, every power that has been hiding under your destiny, tonight we are smoking them out. Tonight they are coming out. Tonight the heat of the fire of the Holy Ghost, because you obey the word of God, the blessings of God will no more pass you. In the name of Jesus, tonight we command the fire to burn. We command the fire to burn. You will burn, oh Lord, and that fire will burn up every viper, will burn up every serpent, will burn up every evil that has been hidden under, that has been destroying your work, that has been stopping you. This viper was in that city. It was, they were raising more barbarians, raising the ones that cannot be able to set up fire, raising the ones that are setting fire, but the fire cannot burn. But there is a man who is coming with more wood, who is coming to set up a proper fire. I see you setting up a proper fire in your family, in your environment, in your kindred. You are setting up a fire, fire that will consume every power that is working under your family, that is destroying things in your family. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, we set that fire to burn them. We set that fire to smoke them out. The fire, the fire, the fire of Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost fire begin to burn in us, begin to destroy every hidden thing, everything that is not of God. The Bible said when the fire burned, then the serpent came out. What he will do is to crawl on the hand of Paul. He fasted and ran upon his hand and beat him. But I tell you what, no matter how I beat him, the God we serve, no matter whatever that are beating your finance, I see you carry that, drop it inside fire. In the name of Jesus, tonight, the fire we set up, we will carry every power, every satanic power, every agent of devil, everything working against you, we carry it and drop it on the fire. We command it to burn by fire. We command it to burn by force. In the name of Jesus, he carried them, he dropped them inside fire, and the fire burned it in, and they were watching. They were saying, very soon this man will die. See, the snake has beaten him. See, this man is a bad man. Oh, Lord, my God, I prophesy to you tonight, all that have been watching to see you stay down, all that has been watching to see you die, tell them that we went and wait, because God is about to do something in your life. God Almighty will turn your story around. Hey, where they expect you to die? David thought that Obed-Edom will die, but Obed-Edom, the story he had is that Obed-Edom has made it. Oh Lord, Obed-Edom is now a champion, is now a great man of God, a great child of God, a great blessed man. He's a sought after man in the city. He's a gatekeeper. The same thing, the barbarians, they were expecting Peter to Paul to die. But what they will see, the Bible said they watch and they talk. So who know what this man has done? I don't know who he's been saying. Who know what you have done? Why did you do anything? You didn't do anything. The issue is that the fire is not testified. Tonight, I join you to set up the fire. I join you to testify the fire of your life, the fire of your foundation, the fire that burns for you. That fire cannot quench. That fire cannot quench. That is why when you see somebody who is always raising fire, no power, fires can, flies can never paint. on a frying pan that is hot. It can never. So tonight, Jesus said, anything that wants to paint all that is under you, working against your life, where a less fire, where a little judgment of God, where a less fire, where a less fire, we smoke them out and we destroy them. We smoke them out and we destroy them. The spectators, the gossipers, the watchers, the one that judge for God, be disappointed, because then we see that your God has turned your life around, that your God has changed your situation, that your God has wiped away your tears, that your God has visited you in the name of Jesus. As they're watching, the Bible says they're watching, God was busy. As they were speaking, God was busy using Paul to intensify the fire. Paul intensified fire. Paul don't look at them. Well, I tell you something. People who know where they are going, they don't listen to gossip. They don't listen to what people are saying. Don't listen to what God is doing. I pray tonight in Jesus' name, you are focused on Christ. You are focused on Christ. You are focused on cross. You are focused on Christ. You are focused on Him. Because you focus on Christ, you are unstoppable. Because you focus on Christ, no power can stop you. No agent or devil can limit you. Nothing can stop you. In the name of Jesus, I declare and declare tonight that you are marching on, that you are moving on. Move on. Holy Ghost fire is burning with His fire. He's burning everything that are tied to your destiny. He's burning every foundation that has been pulling you back. He's burning off every serpent that is connected with your family. He's burning everything that is assigned to mess you up. Holy Ghost fire is burning them. He will burn them off. For the Bible said, in the name of Jesus, we are conquerors. In the name of Jesus, we are winners. God is on your side. Jehovah God is working for you. I decree and declare that the fire of Holy Ghost is working them out, and you are picking them and you are dropping them on fire. They will destroy, and the tongue that speaks will be silent. Shame will turn to them in the name of Jesus, because they will start speaking. These people, this man indeed is a murderer. This man indeed, he has committed sin. This man indeed, he has done something evil. But you know what? The more they talk, the more God gives him sight. The more they call him, the more God moves him further. The more they speak against him, the more God takes him higher. I pray tonight in the name of Jesus, that fire that need to burn on your foundation, to burn off everything that has been working against you, that need to burn in your community, to burn off everything that's speaking against you, that fire that need to burn, that fire is burning tonight. That fire is burning tonight. Yeah, we're born and born off. Yeah, we're born and born off in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, after they watch and watch and watch. For some time, nothing happened. They watch and watch and watch. I tell you, there are many people. They watch and watch and watch. They want to see what is happening. They want to see what God is doing. They want to see how far can you make it, or will you die with it? They will watch and they will see that He who back you up is greater than the greatest. That He who you follow is called the Alpha and Omega. That He who you follow is the one who knows your end from your beginning. That He who you follow said, if you follow Him, He will be your God. He will fight your battle. Oh Lord, He was fighting battle without talking. He was fighting battle with evidence. He was fighting battle with testimony. And God give you testimony that will wipe away your tears. I pray testimony that will wipe away your tears. Testimony that will give you a new song. Testimony that will make you to jubilate. Testimony that will make you to say, indeed, it is good to serve the Lord. Testimony that will cause you to dance. Testimony that will make you, when you open your mouth, all you can say is glory. Testimony that will make you, you want to speak, you cannot be able to speak. He will wipe away your tears. Testimony that he gave to Obed-Edom. I wonder how Obed-Edom feel. The first day, the second day, the third day, 1 month gone. And people began to notice, you cannot hide wealth. You cannot hide the fire of Holy Ghost. If the new fire is burning through you, it cannot be hide. It cannot be hidden. I pray tonight in Jesus' mighty name that God will turn. He turned the pain and the shame and the expectation of the enemy of Paul. the expectation of the enemy's support. He turned it around, and they were watching, and they were looking, and they don't know what to say until they change their mind. May people change their mind. May they who mock you, may they who mock you feel firm to come and see you. May people you beg today, may you become, that's why I tell people, don't look at your condition today. If anybody asks you something, even though you don't have, if it's what you have, divide it and give them half. And believe God, because you know what? People that you depend on today, tomorrow will turn around to depend on you. I pray that Jehovah God, who never fail, who never change, he will turn it around for you. I see you depending on God. I see you moving to higher heights. I see you jubilating and testifying, because the fire has burned whatever that is covering your blessings. The fire of Holy Ghost is burning. It's burning whatever that covers your foundation. The fire of Holy Ghost is consuming that serpent that works against you. By the raising of anointing, yours are destroyed. I speak anointing, anointing, anointing that will carry you to higher heights. Anointing that will bring testimony. Anointing that will cause you to jubilate. I see you jubilating. I see you testifying in the name of Jesus. Our God never fall. The same people now turn their tongue and began to say, with the man they call him vagabond, with the same mountain, the man they call him a killer, when the man they call him that is a great sinner, that God is after him, when the same mouth they began to declare, indeed this man must be a god, indeed this man must be a god, indeed God is with this man. Anywhere they have spoken their own finish and put full stop, God is putting comma to start a new sentence. A sentence of God does not go much. It's just one word or just few words, and things begin to happen. Paul intensified the fire. Paul intensified the fire. The viper came out and thought he would fight Peter. I mean, he would fight Paul. That when he cropped the hand of Paul, that Paul would be a beggar. Paul would be beaten. Paul would be destroyed. Anointing that kill death oppressing you, I pray tonight in the name of Jesus, that anointing will rest upon you. The anointing that destroyed death. Anointing that destroyed death. That is why some of you, you've even come in contact with the plague, but the anointing of God shielded you. Anointing that destroyed death will speak for you. That anointing will speak for you. It wasn't Paul that was speaking, but the anointing was busy speaking for him. I say the anointing is speaking for you in the name of Jesus. You are untouchable because of divine immunity. When Christ finished on the cross, he declared over you, it is finished. And he said to us, he said, it is finished in the name of Jesus. 2020, anointing that killed death is resting upon you. The power that is causing the vagabonds to stay there, the power that is been setting you back, the power that is been walking under you, when you want to move forward, you will see you can go. I come today, I stand with you in faith, in agreement, as a prophet of God. I say your fire will be testified. We testify your fire. We testify your fire. We testify your fire. Let your fire begin to burn. Let your fire begin to burn. Let your fire begin to burn. Every viper on your family root, every viper on your foundation, every viper in the house you are living, whatever it is, whatever foundation, whatever they use in the foundation, whatever they use against you, fire of Holy Ghost, burn them. I will carry them. They will run out. I will carry them. I will drop them on the higher fire. Lord, higher fire. I join my faith with you to testify your fire, to increase your fire. The fire, the fire, the fire that was burning, but you are still committing sin because the fire is not intensified. Tonight, that fire is intensified in the name of Jesus. Tonight, that fire will speak for you. The Lord is intensifying your fire. That fire that set you back, you go one step ahead and you see, I said, go 10 miles backwards. Tonight, I come to declare over you, your fire is burning. Hey, Holy Ghost fire, fire fall on me. Holy Ghost fire, fire, fire fall on me. Like in the days of Pentecost, Fire follow me. Like in the days of Pentecost, fire follow me. Fire of Holy Ghost upon you. The fire that can make devil, when he smell the smell of your fire, it will be running away. I pray that's the fire that God is releasing upon you tonight. That fire will speak upon you. That fire will rest upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we serve God. Our God never fell. Our God never changed. I see the fire speaking for you. I see the fire burning of everything that is not of God. That you are serving God, but you are still lying because the fire is not testified. When the fire come on you, you are bold. Everything about you will be on fire. Whatsoever that want to attack you, the fire will destroy them. Whatsoever that thought he can beat you to release valor, oh, power will mean power, because the power in you is the greater than the one that is in the viper, and the viper will be destroyed. In Jesus' mighty name, we destroy them this afternoon. Destroy them. I join my faith with you to crumble and destroy everything that has been standing against you in the name of Jesus. And the Bible said to us, he said to us in the book of Isaiah 48, verse 18, he said, Oh, that you had heed my commandments, then your peace we have been like a river, and your righteousness like a wave of the sea. When you obey God, your peace become like river. It's river that flows. Enemy cannot stop it, because enemy didn't give it to you. I pray today in Jesus' mighty name, the peace of God that surpasses every human understanding, the peace of God in a time of famine, the peace of God in a time of trouble, the peace of God in a time of challenge is coming upon you. It will flow through you. It will walk with you. That peace will speak for you. When God's presence is with you, he gives you peace. That's why he told us in the book of Exodus, Exodus 33. Father God, we thank you. We bless you for your peace tonight, O Lord. We thank you, unchangeable God, for your peace. What your peace will do for us, because you are blessing us with peace. O Lord, we thank you. He said to us in the book of Exodus, Exodus 33, verse 13. He said, now therefore I pray thee, if I find grace in thy sight, show me now thy way, that I may know thee, that I may find grace in thy sight, and consider that this nation is thy people. 14. God said, my peace shall go with thee, and I will give you the rest. I will give thee rest. And 15 said, and he said unto him, if thy presence go not with me, carry us not hence. You see, this is a man who has been with God's presence. But time came. My brothers and sisters, sons and daughters, we need God's presence. We need him in a time like this. If Paul did not have that God's presence, Paul would have been destroyed. Paul would have been ruined. And Paul wouldn't have done what he did. But when the presence of God was with him, despite how the barbarians, how they treated him, it doesn't matter how people treat you. Focus on what God is doing with you. The Bible said that in that very place, something happened. The Bible said this man now, not only that he healed all the sick, he's the barbarians now. We're telling people, come, there is a man of God. Come, there is a man of God. And all of them start coming. And as they are coming, they were getting healed. So they said they went to the king's village. And the mother was sick. And the father was sick. And they prayed for them and they get well. And they blessed them. And they left and moved on to another place. Where I'm going is this. When God's presence is with you, the difference is always clear. The difference is clear. When God's presence is with you, flies cannot perch on you. Evil cannot near you. Nothing can come. If they come around, that will never penetrate, because there is a divine shield. There is shield that is covering you. He said, they that put their trust in the Lord. He said, as the wall surrender, as the mountain surrenders Jerusalem, so has the Lord surrendered them. That is how God is to you. They can never penetrate into. But at times what happens is that we are not hot and we are not cold. But when the man of God came, he set on the fire to higher height. The fire began to burn. And that the same thing happened with Moses. Moses said, I will not go. If your presence will not go with me, please don't carry me. I won't go. I pray tonight in Jesus' mighty name that God's presence will carry you, that God's presence will speak for you, that God's presence will locate you in the name of Jesus. And when God's presence located him, something powerful happened. I pray to God Almighty. Father, Lord, let your presence locate your daughters this morning. Let this night, oh Lord, let your presence speak over your people today in the name of Jesus. When the presence came, impossible became possible. When the presence came, it got the power, everything bow at his presence. A man that carries his presence, everything happened. When Moses carried God's presence, he was able to stand before Pharaoh that he was running away from, the palace he was running away from because of what he did. But God said to him, my presence will go with you from today in Jesus' name. God's presence will be with you. God's presence will stay in your house with you. God's presence will overshadow you. God's presence will empower you. God's presence will show you favor. God's presence will envelop you in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare God's presence over your life. When God's presence come upon a man, it's God's presence that made them to leave a land without asking. Somebody that carry God's presence, do not bother for what he will eat or what he will drink. He do not assess these dangers. It's because people do not more care for God's presence. That's why we always afraid. And I pray tonight in Jesus' mighty name, God's presence will go ahead of you. God's presence will bring transformation in your life. God's presence, oh Lord. God's presence that when Moses carried the people of Israel, when they reached there, when they looked back, they saw the enemy coming. But the river is in their front. Where are we going? At times it looks as if there is no way. At times it looks as if nothing will happen. At times it looks, you don't know where you're going. But today, I tell you in Jesus' mighty name, God's presence is going to lead you. God's presence is leading you. He's taking you. Moses said, if your presence do not go with us, don't carry us. Don't let us go. Leave us where we are. Lord, it's your presence that changes situation. It's your presence that brings transformation. It's your presence that wipes away tears. It's your presence that makes it possible to be possible. We pray, Jehovah God, your presence will not depart from us. Hey, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, we welcome you. Holy Spirit, reign and rule in our midst. Holy Spirit, have your way. Holy Spirit, don't abandon us. We need you, oh Lord. Without you, we cannot live in this end time. Without you, when we join them to live a life of end time spirit, Lord God, it will not be a portion. Without you, oh Lord, when we'll be looking for miracle. Without you, oh Lord, when we'll be looking for you, when we'll be looking for a miracle, we'll be looking for a God of men instead of men of God or servants of God. Father God, we pray thee, oh Lord. We need you, Jehovah God. We need you a shade of this. Don't let your presence leave us. It's the presence of God that when he got, he was crying. They were crying. I cried to him. He said, what are you crying for? He said, where are we going to go? Mountain by the side, valley by the other side. The back is the enemy. The front is the water. Hey, Lord God, is the sea. Waiting there, waiting. Where will they go? There is no way. He said, what is that is with you? He said, the rod. He said, stretch it. That rod, it speaks of God's presence because God empowers it. I pray tonight, God will empower your rod. God will empower your rod with his presence. It's when God empowered the rod that he used to kill an Egyptian, the rod that was the only thing he left with in the house or in the land of Egypt.
The rod was one leading into the house of Jethro. The rod was what he used to go and lead the sheep by the desert side. It was the same rod that God saw and asked him, "What is it that is in your hand?" After the experience of the burning fire, there is power in God's fire. When God's present fire come upon you, something happened. Moses thought it's as usual. Today he's taking the sheep to go out, to go and walk around, to go and feed them. As he was going, he saw fire burning. He saw fire burning. He looked back. He didn't know that God wanted to burn off every power that is holding him back, every power that has been delaying his life. Today, in Jesus' mighty name, your eyes is seeing fire. Your eyes will feel fire. Holy Ghost will burn up every power, every covering cast, everything that is covering your glory, that is covering you from seeing him, that is covering you from moving forward, that is covering you from reaching out to him. In the name of Jesus, he saw the fire. When he saw the fire, he said, "Let me come and see why is this fire burning, but it never consumed." The Bible says, when he turned, he saw that it was fire. He wanted to make a move. He moved 1, 2, 3 steps. God says, "Stop there, for the ground while they are standing is a holy ground." Oh Lord, my God, I pray today in the name of Jesus. From today, there will be an encounter with the fire of Holy Ghost that will burn you and bring you out of every Jethro's house, out of every house that you are, that you shouldn't be, every condition you are, that you shouldn't be. I see the fire of Holy Ghost setting you free. I see the fire of Holy Ghost setting you free. It's the same fire where he saw, he said to him, nobody told us what happened to the sheep, but he said to him, he said, "Take off your shoe in the name of Jesus. Every shoe enemy has put on your leg." The Lord is taking off your leg today. In the name of Jesus, I speak upon your leg. The leg, you are sure we put the leg. The Lord need the leg. The Lord will use the leg. He will use the leg to evangelize. He will use the leg to do his work. He will use the leg to send you an errand. He will use your leg. But the leg cannot stay in Jethro's house. At the same time, want to work for me. Take off that shoe. For where you stand is a holy ground. In the name of Jesus, you are moving into his presence with a holy ground. You are moving into his presence that is a holy ground. When he entered into that holy ground, something began to happen. He and God discussion starts. He went and told the father-in-law. He said, "I am going. Wherever they hold you back, you are going to make announcement to them. You are going to tell them you are going. You cannot remain there. They cannot hold you back because you are special. They can't think that you are in their house. You are around them and you're an ordinary person. You are not an ordinary person. You are a royal priesthood who's supposed to minister for the Lord, who's supposed to work for the kingdom. You cannot be where you are now. Get off the shoe." And he went back, he told them, he said, "I'm sorry, I'm going, the Lord called me." And that was how he went. From there, changes start. God began to ask him, "What is it? Go and tell my people. I have prepared you, I have raised you for a time like this. That is why when you are to die, when they are killing other children, I preserve you, I keep you. That is why I cause the prince to train you, because I'm God of purpose." Today, maybe people look at you and say they don't know where you're going. Yes, you know where you're going, because God is gone ahead of you, because God will bring changes, because God will transform you, because God will wipe away your tears, because God will change your stories. You may be there doing that miniature. That doesn't make you to be who you are. You are different. Your case is different. You are different. Your case is different. Because God is preparing you to do a great thing. He's preparing you to use you for great job. He's preparing you to use you for something powerful. In the name of Jesus. When Moses eventually agreed, God said to him, "You will go and tell them. Go and tell the elders of Israel that I am that I am. Have called me." He said, "How can I go? They will not believe me." "What is that thing you have in your hand?" I had the rod, he said, drop it. He dropped it on the ground. He turned to snake. He said, pick it from there. From today, in Jesus' mighty name, every viper that wants to stand against you, that wants to walk against you, heaven is swallowing them up. And God is empowering your rod. And God empowered his rod. And God asked him to pick it up by tail. He pick it up by tail. He said, what do you have? He said, what is in your hand? He said, nothing. He said, put it in your pocket. He put it in his pocket. He brought it out to show his sin, leprosy in his hand, because he was carrying blood in his hand. But thank God for God of mercy. He said, so he put it back. He put it back. He pulled it out. And in his hand, what did he see? He saw, what did he see? He saw a fresh, clean hand. No more leprosy. No more stain. No, blessed is he. Who God do not count their sins, but forgive their iniquities. And then God forgive him. And then now he went. He said to him, go and tell them. He said, who will I tell them? He said, tell them I am Abraham. Hey, Lord, I don't know who God is to you. I don't know what you call him. Is he the Alpha to you? Is he the Omega to you? Is he the Almighty God? Is he your provider? Is he your helper? Is he your deliverer? Is he your King of Kings? Is he your Lord of Lords? Is he your refuge? Is he your high place? Is he your Almighty God? Is he your Eternal Father? Is he your helper? Is he your deliverer? He said, go and tell them, whatsoever they say unto them, that's why he said, but they will not believe me. I said to you today, whatever name you call God today, that's who God is. God will power your rod. God will power your word. God will power the word of God, which is the rod that is in your mouth today. God will power your rod in the name of Jesus. As you are speaking to people, and people who thought you cannot have voice, you cannot stand before them, God send him. Go back to that place where they have fought you. Go back to the place you're running away, for I have prepared you there. Oh, the man that you thought that was there is dead. I have raised a new king. In Jesus' mighty name, God is sending you to a place you couldn't get to. You will begin to enter where you couldn't enter in life. You will begin to go to the place where you fear. The things you fear will begin to fear you because of his presence. When you carry God's presence, powers fear you. Agent of devil fear you. Satanic powers fear you. I said to you, God is sending you. That's why God is raising many of us. That's why you must raise up and stand strong. Join me with testify fire. That way we release fire in Nigeria as a nation. That every viper that is occupying Nigeria, every power, every agent of devil that is sitting over Nigerian leadership, all of them, that God will begin to chase them out and begin to chase the powers of wickedness, the powers of agent of devils, the wicked ones in leadership. God is chasing them out, that the children of God will be able to see the light of God in the name of Jesus. They are praying, but their prayer is not, their fire is not testified enough. Lord God, tonight, oh Lord, I join them to testify their fire. We join them, Holy Ghost fire. Fire up our nation. Fire up Africa. Fire up Africa. Fire up Africa. Africa, what have you done? Who have caused you? Whatever that has come to land in you, today we release the fire of Holy Ghost to begin to burn. Burn from the head of all the leaders. Burn them, oh Lord. Born and born and born, that they may begin to declare, thus says the Lord, that if your God will come upon them, in the mighty name of Jesus, I declare tonight that Lord will empower your rod with his presence. Presence of God will never depart from you. Presence of God will never depart from you. Any man, there is something that ex-president of America said, Senior George Bush, he said, a man that knows where he's going, people will always make a way for him. But you see, when your fire is not burning, when you don't know whether you are to pray or not to pray, when you don't know where you are going, anything can push you around. Anything can take your attention. But I tell you something. Jesus knows where he's going. And he has come to show us the way. And we will follow that way. In the name of Jesus. Nothing can stop us from going. Nothing can limit us from going. You are going somewhere, child of God. You may be locked down in the house. But you are preparing to go somewhere. You are preparing because you are going somewhere. You are ready to go somewhere. Because it's your rock. Oh Lord, this day is broken. And your son is in escape. Because your help is in the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Whatsoever that is afraid of. Whatsoever you are afraid of. The power of Holy Ghost is smoking them out. The ancient of this is taking over your battle. In the name of Jesus. Fear not, for our God is our rock. Fear not, for he is our king. Fear not, for he is our Jehovah. He is our deliverer. He is the ancient of days. He is the ancient of days. When he appears in the book of Daniel, the Bible says the people that were winning the children of God, when the ancient of days appears, all of them began to run. They know that he has come. And he took over the war. I pray in the name of Jesus. Every battle you are going through in life, a shift of this is taking over. It's taking over. Fear not, for the Lord is with you. Fear not, for the Lord is with you. Fear not, for the Lord cannot change. Fear not, for the Lord cannot disappoint you. He's our God, he's our Lord, he's our King, he's our helper. Fear not, shake not, for the Lord is with you. I prophesy over you. The rod in your hand, that rod, the little you have in your hand. The Bible said to us that Jesus Christ went and prayed. After praying with his disciple, after praying, him and the disciple, with the people that followed him and stayed with him for 3 days. And the Bible said that the disciples came to him and said to him, Master, is it not time to let these people go? For night has come. Let them go, or else evil may befall them on the way going. Even though they brought good idea, but the way they brought their reports is not the way God expects them to speak. And Jesus said to them, he asked them, who has something? The Bible said he asked Philip, he said, where can we buy bread that we may feed these people? And Philip said to him, even though you have 100 denarii, that means 100 pounds, it's not enough for you to buy the bread that will cover these people. But the Bible said he said it to prove it. And the Bible said, while he was talking, Peter now came to him, said, there is a lad here with only 5 loaves of bread and 2 pieces of fish. He said, go and bring it. The lad did not say, no, I won't give it to you. The lad gave the little he had. God marked his book in the name of financial distributors. In the mighty name of Jesus, whatever little you've been giving to the church you've been worshiping, I come to prophesy to you tonight that anointing of a blessing point of contact, that you will be a distributor of wealth. You will be a distributor of blessing. You will be a distributor in the name of Jesus. Not what the cultic world is distributing. Now it's opportunity for them to chuck their food into people's life. But God is raising army without greed. And you are among that army. Army that you can willingly submit. There are 5 loaves of bread and 2 pieces of fish. And the Bible says, God, Jesus said to Peter, he said, make them to sit down. And they all sat down. And now the multiplication started. Jesus took the 5 loaves of bread. He broke. He passed on to the disciples. He took it. He lifted it up. He said, Father, thank you. and then the increase starts. I decree and declare tonight that little you have in your hand, the God answered by fire, the God of the widow woman who turned her from mockery to oil merchant, the God that caused the armies of Israel who seek their blessing, who caused them to stay in famine. He caused them with echoes of war. In the book of 2 Kings chapter 7, if you can read it down, the Bible says when the echo of war came, all of them abandoned everything. The army, they removed their clothes, they ran away. All they besieging for life against the children of Israel. The children of Israel went and packed it. Man, answer you in the name of Jesus. The little in your hand, Jehovah God will begin to multiply it as you obey his voice, as you honor him, as you serve him, as you keep his commandment in truth and the spirit. The little in your hand, the Lord will multiply it. Ancient of Days will multiply. I am that I am will multiply. Immortal Redeemer will multiply. God that never fell. Five loaves of bread and 2 pieces of fish to feed a nation. 5,000 men. When you talk of men, women are not counted there. Children are not counted. They count men as number one. And men, 5,000. Father God, we thank you that we are in a season of grace, that women are counted, that women are important as well. Father God, I thank you. In the season of your love, that children, oh Lord, you say, let them come to me. We thank you, Jehovah God, for little in our hand. Your love will cause it to fill our family. In the name of Jesus, 5 loaves of bread will feed a nation. I prophesy to you, that little you have, God is increasing it. Jehovah God is increasing it. Miracle working God is increasing it. He will increase in your life. He will increase in your life. From today, mark it down. You will not lack. You will not need. Because the little, because of the word of God, the presence of God, is hitting your pocket. It's God of multiplication. It's God of increase. I've experienced it when I didn't have any money. When I don't know where to get the money, I look up and look down. There was no hope. He said to me, go and read your Bible. Start complaining. As I opened my Bible, I saw brand new 50 pounds. That was then, about 1985. Oh, Lord God. To you, it's nothing. But to me, I know what it is. Today, it may not mean anything. But then, when I needed it, when I needed God, God show up for me. God will show up for you. The little in your hand shall increase. The little in your hand shall increase. As long as you serve God, as long as you honor God, God will begin to increase it. I speak increase. I speak multiplication in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, all eight. Remember, it's only 5 loaves of bread and 2 pieces. Perfect number of God and 2 pieces. And God said, after that, what happened? God not told him. He said, gather it. Make sure not it waste. As they gather, how many baskets do they got? They got 12 full baskets. Every month, every basket God has supplied for you. He said, God daily load us with this benefit. I pray this night, the benefit that God has loaded you with will never leave you. He will stay with you in the name of Jesus. He loaded us with his benefit. He loaded us with his blessing. As he began to release, something began to happen. As he began to release, every month you carry a basket. Every month you carry a basket. And that basket, every good blessing is inside the basket of Christ. Basket of God is not basket of wickedness. It's basket of favor. It's basket of healing. It's basket of righteousness. It's basket of peace. In every blessing, every need, anything you will eat is inside. Everything that you needed is inside. I pray this night that in Jesus' mighty name, that you will begin to see the mighty hand of Christ. You will begin to see his hand of mercy. You will begin to see his hand of favor. You will begin to see his hand of grace in the name of Jesus. Nothing can stop you. Nothing can limit you. You are going further. You are going further. I prophesy into your finance. I prophesy into your finance. I prophesy into your finance. Because enemy always use finance to make mockery of children of God. That is why when he grabbed Christ, first thing he did was to nail his two hands. That is why when the enemy want to fight Paul, first thing he do was to crawl in his hand, so that people who will give you tomorrow will turn around and make mockery of you. But thank God for Jesus. We serve him who never fail. We serve him who never change. The fire of Holy Ghost is burning off everything that is not of him. He's burning off everything that stands against him. He's burning off everything that works against you. Your basket, you will carry. No diversion. No power will take it. No power will remove it. I decree and declare that basket, in the 12 basket that God has prepared for you, remember, it's from two fish and five loaves of bread. God began to multiply. Increase began to come. Increase is coming your way. The little you have, God will increase it. Many times, I've seen women, mothers with single children, because they serve God, they focus on God, with many, many children. Before you know it, they never borrow, they never lack, but because God increased the little they have, they are faithful in their tithing. They are faithful in giving. They are faithful in everything. God began to increase them. I pray tonight, increase will come your way. Jehovah God will increase you. The little in your hand will never finish. The little in your hand will never finish. What you fear in life will begin to fear you. What you fear most in life will fear you the most, because you fear God. When you fear God, poverty fear you. When you fear God, spirit of lack fear you. When you fear God, untimely death fear you. When you fear God, shame fear you. When you fear God, sorrow fear you. When you fear God, everything fear you, because they know you daily bow before God. You know, they know that you have everything that you need. The basket of multiplication, the basket of his increase, because of his presence, the basket cannot increase. The basket cannot work if the presence is not there. It was bought by his presence. To maintain it, we remain in his presence. I pray today in Jesus' mighty name that we will remain in God's presence. We will not be the one who will run away from his presence. When we stay in his presence, when Jonah ran away from his presence, he knew where he find himself. He find himself in the belly of fish. He find himself in a wrecking ship. He find himself in agony for days. But when obey God, God change it for him. I pray today in Jesus' mighty name, his presence will always go ahead of you. It's his presence when they were crying, and God, when Pharaoh was boasting in the book of Exodus 14, verse 2, he said, leave them, they are trapped, they are not going anywhere, they are trapped. Oh yes, that's what the enemy is saying to you, you are trapped. But today, because the fire of Holy Ghost has burned off the foundation, and the serpent has been smothered and destroyed, he cannot limit you. He cannot stop you again. In the name of Jesus, you are going higher. You are moving higher. You are moving higher. You are moving to a better level. In the name of Jesus, no power can stop a child of God. No power can limit a child of God. If a child of God is serving God, a child of God knows the God they serve. No matter the power that comes against you, they will bow. Because in the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. In the name of Jesus, all situation must bow. I announce to you, in Jesus' name, the little you have, God will increase it. He's God of surprises. He's God of surprises. He will surprise you. He will surprise you. He will surprise you. And disappoint expectation of the enemy. How they expected to see Obididon drop and die. Obididon, instead of dropping to die, Obididon was catapulted. How they expected for Paul to drop and die. Instead of Paul to die, his name went firm. The work of God increased and multiplied. How they expected that, how can they get money to feed the people? But God did something. How they expected, how Jethro expected, he's gotten an in-law who will be his cattle rear, who will be his shepherd boy. And God said, no, that's not where I put him. Wherever God didn't put you, God will relocate your position. God will change your position. Jehovah God will change your position. I declare change in position. I speak change in position. In this lockdown, you will come and testify. In this lockdown, you will come and jubilate. In this lockdown, you will come and celebrate. In the name of Jesus, because as you stay inside, God is changing. He's removing things. He's destroying foundation that is not right. He destroys whatsoever that is attacking that foundation. He brings it to naught. He's disarming them. He's decapitating them. He's making public show of them. He's taking you to higher height. He's taking you to a place of honor and glory. He will increase the little you have in your hand. No man become great without God making you great. I pray in Jesus' mighty name, you will be great. The Lord will increase you, people, from glory to glory, from power to power, from anointing to anointing, from favor to favor, from grace to grace, from mercy to mercy, from honor to honor, in the name of Jesus. God that empowered the rod of Moses will empower his rod in your life. He will empower his rod in your life. That rod will be empowered in the name of Jesus. The fire of Holy Ghost will never leave you. The fire of Holy Ghost will stay in you. It will burn through you. It will burn off every shaft, every serpent, every evil, every agent that is walking secretly under you. God is burning them off. I join my faith once more with you to destroy them. We destroy them. We set them on fire. We set them on fire. They will not see you. On your mother's side, they will not see you. On your father's side, they will not see you. In the name of Jesus. For Christ didn't die in vain. He died that you may find peace. He died that you may testify. In the name of Jesus, I decree and declare that whatsoever you fear will turn out to testimony. It will turn out to testimony. Enemy wanted that they will destroy. Pharaoh said that they will destroy. But God said, I will make a way. God, you are a way maker. Lord, your presence, don't let your presence depart from us. Empower us with your presence. Empower us with your presence. We need your presence in shape of this. We need your presence in your life. Without your presence, oh Lord, we are done. Father, but your presence make a great difference. Your presence separate us. Your presence, oh Lord, remove the shaft in us and bring the seed in us. Father, that presence, make the little we have, increase it in us. Your presence, oh Lord, make us to stand before kings and queens and declare your word. Father God, we thank you. Jehovah God, we bless you. Miracle working God, we adore you. You are God, oh Lord. Oh Lord, my God. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Ha ra ba 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 yanda. Derebo sukataya. Ha da 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 yanda. Renderebo. Ha ra ba 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 yema yeke. Makro koto sokoto. Yes, Lord. We thank you, Jehovah God. If not you on our side, oh Lord, where would we have been? Is Christ in us the hope of our glory? We no longer live, and Christ liveth in us. Oh Lord, there is somebody online. Oh Lord, my God, whatever you fear, God is saying to you tonight, fear not, for I am with thee. I am with thee. I have empowered your rod. I have empowered your foundation. You are on the faith foundation now. You are no more in the foundation of destruction. God is with you. God is with you. Jehovah God is with you. He's turning it around for you. No more weeping, no more sorrow, for the snare is broken and your soul has been escaped like that of a bird, for your help is in the name of the Lord. The Lord is saying to somebody, fear not, I am with you. You are afraid, what will your life talk? You are afraid of what you expect. How can you handle it? Is life going to disappoint me? Is life going to do this? Oh Lord, my God. The Bible, I heard the Lord say, give him, Jeremiah 29:11. My thought towards you is to give you good end. Lord is going to bless you. God is going to change it. Fear not. The things you fear will turn for good. As long as you fear the Lord, as long as you obey the Lord, as long as you are in the Lord will turn it around for you. I want you to know, he's the one who can use nothing to make something. He's the one that used clear to open the eyes of a blind man. He's the one that his wind causes the dry bone to come back to life and raise great army. That's the God I'm telling you about. I'm a living testimony of what he can do. The Lord said, fear not. He said, fear not. Fear not. Many of you are so much afraid. Afraid of tomorrow. Afraid what will happen. He died for you that you may have everlasting life. Somebody have told you that he will deal with you. Tell them, cause let's not return back to sender. For Jesus Christ has become a cause for you that you may be cause free. You cannot be cause because Christ has become a cause that you may be cause free. Any power holding any wound in this place, anybody that is here, and the enemy is holding your womb. You see yourself giving birth. You see yourself, you will get pregnant. After, the pregnant will not be. I terminate the assignment today. I join my faith with you and command the hand of the enemy to wither over you. In the name of Jesus, God of newness, Lord, do something new. And the life of this sister, oh Lord, open up her womb, oh Lord. From now, Jehovah God, to 3 months' time, there will be a testimony. And this person will testify in a day like this, in the name of Jesus, that the Lord has visited them and they has turned their pains. He has disappointed the counsel of the enemy and they have brought to nothing the boasting of the enemy, and that their soul has been escaped like that of a bird. And there is a sister, anytime you want to make a move for marriage, in short, there was a marriage you had to do about a year ago. But that marriage at the dying minute, it was canceled because there is Ziba behind you, a household wickedness, who is witnessing against you, who is speaking against you. Today, in Jesus' name, the Lord has burn off that satanic garment that is pointing against your tomorrow. He's burn it off. God will remove the filthy garment from Joshua, the high priest. The same God is able to remove it from you and your family and set you free in the name of Jesus. I see somebody jubilating. Every spirit of fear of death, I terminate you. I burn you to ashes in the name of Jesus. Why are you afraid? You are afraid of death. Even when you walk, you begin to say, in case I die, in case this, what is in case? You are not going to die. For the rod of God is strong in your life. The rod of God that part the ocean is parting the ocean of sickness from you to your household. Whatever that kill others, they cannot kill you because you're praying under a new covenant. Oh, Lord, my God. Ah, Jehovah God. Thank you for your hand that is upon your children tonight. Thank you for opening heaven. Thank you for somebody who have appointment. You have appointment of interview. And that interview, before you speak 2-3 days, we say, don't worry, we've taken you. Just go. It, because of the favor that has gone ahead of you. I see the favor of God speaking over you. In the name of Jesus. Every child of God who has gone through shame and pain, I see God changing your story. I see God visiting you. God of divine visitation is turning it around for you. He's bringing peace. You are online, but peace you never have for some months is just flowing through you. It's just flowing through you right now. Increase of peace. Increase of peace. I speak peace in your home. I speak peace in your soul. I speak peace in your life. That's the first thing God told us. He said that he will restore the dying soul. He will revive it again. He will restore it in the book of Jeremiah 15:25. Read it and meditate on it. Remind God of his word. There is blessing. There is favor. Somebody weeping. Your season of weeping is over. I tell you the truth. Outside there, after all these things, there will be a great famine, but the famine will not near you. Because in famine, our God, he is Lord. He will make a way for you. He will change your story and he will change situation. We have to pray for Nigerians. I keep on saying this. Please, wherever you are, even if you are not in Nigeria, pray for Nigerians. There is a battle all over the world coming against Nigerians. Wherever they are, in the whole Africa, wherever they are, even in Asia, wherever they are, even in Europe, there will be attack on them. There will be attack on them. People will be fighting them. People will be killing them. But I know something, that God, they will not touch yours. They will not touch any of your people because you stand today in covenant that is under this mandate that no man dies untimely dead here. and you can none of yours, the covenant will split into your family. No death in Jesus' mighty name. None of you will be marked for timely death. God has seen and know it. God that walk on our behalf. God that defend and protect us, our sustainer, our refuge, our hiding place. I ask you, oh Lord, if the dead lion come looking for food, preserve the feet of your remnants in the name of Jesus. So many killing this year, but they will not see remnants to kill. They will not see your family. They will not see you. They will not near of you in the name of Jesus. Death just started in Nigeria. Many of the leaders, the other day I pray, I say, Lord, if they don't change, evacuate them from the earth. It's an instruction given. The Bible said, when prophet speaks, God hear. I sit under my office of prophecy, and I prophesy tonight that any man sitting over that nation, that the people are crying, that has made them their prayer, their fire is not burning strong, because everybody is putting fire, looking for, is the food ready already, but food is not cooking. Lord God, I pray thee, O Lord, every cauldron set up by any leader in that nation, Father, their head will fall into it. Their head will begin to fall into it. The remnants will be saved. Father, raise armies of Christ. Raise armies that will fight for you. Raise armies that will go and stand at the gate to ask enemy, what is it that you are saying? In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. We bless you, O Lord. We thank you because I know, Lord, there will be a great turnaround. Your season of sweat, before you make money is coming to an end. Because now the world are waiting for your manifestation. What you are doing in this secret, what the gift God has blessed you with, is about to begin to manifest in the public. That is why you have to make sure that you prepare. And prepare yourself this time you are in his presence so that he can take you to higher heights. Father, we thank you. Wipe away the tears of your children. Thank you for we have dealt with the foundation of challenges today. Fire has burned. You have dealt for us, O Lord, with your children who don't know where to turn to. Your fire has come to burn off and separate them from the hand of wandering, from the leg of wandering, from the life of confusion, and set them right to where they will be. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Jehovah God. Thank you, miracle working God. Thank you for the continent of Africa. Thank you for the continents, O Lord, of Europe. Thank you for North and South America. Thank you for Asia, O Lord. Thank you for every one of us that is on the line. For all the nations, all the continents of the world that are on the line. Father, bless your people. Lord, let every one of them be a point of contact to light up where they come from, to light up the land, to light up their place. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Daddy. May the Lord bless you. Let me pray for you. Father, Heavenly Father, I thank you. Miracle working God, I appreciate you for who you are. I bless your name. I just want you to begin to thank God for where you are. Begin to thank him. Thank him, thank him, thank him, thank him, thank the Lord. Ask him to carry the rumors of death and drop it in the camp of the enemy that said that he will not let you see peace. That God will drop it upon their head. In Jesus' mighty name, that no more serpent will crawl upon your hand, and no more serpent. You will not feed serpent again with a warm fire. They will burn to ashes, and it will smoke out and get destroyed. Lord, destroy them, O Lord, as I pray for your people. No serpent will come after me. Whatever that attack them will not come after me, because the fire of Holy Ghost will burn them to ashes in Jesus' mighty name. Your children are set free. They are set free. They are set free. Father, we bless you. We thank you for your mercy and grace. Thank you, miracle working God. Thank you for all that is on the line. Father, bless every one of them. Strengthen them, O Lord. Let your mighty hand rest upon them. For Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Amen. Okay, we see tomorrow morning at our usual time, London time, 11:30. God bless you. But I think, that's right. God bless you. You see what I'm trying to say, whether we could move it to maybe 1 o'clock so that we can get the Americans to come in, the Asians to come in, so that they can be part of what we are doing, because it's only Europe and Africa that can come in when we come in. So may God bless every one of us in Jesus' mighty name. I will get back to you. I will come back to you. If the Holy Spirit say remain on the time, I will remain there. And if you want us to move so that others will join us, and they say remain there, if it's going to be a price that we pay to be able to come in on time, they will still pay the price and come in and be blessed. And may God bless every one of you in Jesus' mighty name. We all at home. Thank you so much. Love you all. Bye.